Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this video. This video is all about wealth through inheritance. Alright, so let me talk to you a little bit of basics about wealth, and also let me talk to you about inheritance. Alright, so the karakas for wealth are basically Jupiter and Venus. Okay, most importantly, Jupiter is considered as an auspicious planet out of 9 planets. So, and also Venus is considered as an auspicious planet in terms of wealth gain. So, most importantly, Jupiter and Venus placement matters a lot in our birth chart. Okay, the kind of placements, the kind of planetary alignment that we have with regards to Jupiter and Venus talks about your wealth. Okay, and also your second house and 11th house talks about wealth prospects. Okay, I have made so many videos related to wealth astrology. Please do check those videos also. And also the primary contributors for inheritance are Mars and Mercury. Okay, if at all second house lord happened to be Mars and is placed in the fourth house, this indicates that wealth through inheritance, wealth through ancestral property. And similar way, second house happened to be Mercury, if it is placed in the fourth house, this happens, the wealth happens through the purchase of a land or sale of a property. Okay, purchase and sale, both it talks about fourth house. So around the second house lord placed in the 8th house, this also indicates that you'll be gaining wealth through ancestral property. Okay, and similar way, Mercury and Mars and also Sun work so well. Those planets happen to be second house and should be placed in the 8th house. So any strong placement, any strong planetary alignment happened with second house, 4th house and 8th house brings the success in terms of gaining wealth through inheritance. Alright, and also we need to check the D9 chart, that is Navamsha chart. Why Navamsha chart? Because after the age of 30, Navamsha chart will get activated. So after the age of 30, we need to check the Lagna chart as well as Navamsha chart, which is D9 chart. And also D10 chart also has to be checked. If at all you are looking for wealth through service or through business, we need to check the D10 chart, which is called as Dashamsha chart. Okay, and also D4 chart, if possible, has to analyze in terms of landed gains and property. Okay, so please stick to the basics. Once you understood the basics, it is very easy for you to analyze the birth chart. And also, if at all you are having any kind of wealth yogas like Dharma Karma Adhipati yogas or Lakshmi yoga or Bhagya yoga or Gajakeshari yoga, these people are also destined to gain a lot of wealth through property as well as sale of property. And if the second lord happened to be sitting in the fourth house and the fourth house lord happened to be placed in the 12th house, this indicates losses through property. Similar way, 8th house lord placed in the 12th house also indicates losses through properties. Okay, so we need to analyze the birth chart in terms of understanding who happened to be the second house lord, who happened to be 4th house lord, where exactly they placed, if at all there is any malefic aspect on the 4th house or 2nd house. All these things has to be thoroughly analyzed. Alright, so this is a short bite video on wealth through inheritance. Thank you so much for watching this video. If at all you are watching this video for the first time, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on that bell icon next to subscribe button so that you'll be notified for the future videos. Alright, and also I would like to tell you that I have made so many videos on wealth astrology in my YouTube channel. Please do check those videos also. And if at all you need my consultations, the link is mentioned in the description section. Do book for an astrology consultation. Once I get a consultation order, I'll be able to help you with the complete analysis pertaining to your individual birth chart. And your individual predictions are totally different from the general predictions. Whatever I'm talking to you is a general prediction here. So if at all you need your individual astrology prediction, you have to provide us the date of birth, time of birth and the place of birth, so that it will enable us to check your birth chart and analyze your birth chart at least for 2 to 3 hours, and then we'll be providing you the final prediction. Alright, so thank you so much for watching this video, and let me know in the comment section what exactly you learned from this video, what exactly you loved from this video, so that I know that you are following my videos. And click on that like button if at all you loved this video, and stay tuned, I'll meet you in the next video. Bye for now.